Polyatomic ions are really kind of a big deal in chemistry, and we use them extensively when we're naming and writing formulas for different compounds. I recommend you memorize these core polyatomic ions, and you'll see why later in the video. Some instructors, they let you use the list of common polyatomic ions on exams, but check to be sure. And if you're not allowed to use one, ask which ones you need to know. So in this video, you learn to memorize the polyatomic ions, and then you'll learn how to use the common polyatomic ion table. Let's get started. Polyatomic ions are groups of tightly bound nonmetals like NH4+ or PO43-. They tend to stay together. For example, if you put NaNO3 in water, it would dissolve into Na+, that's the sodium ion, and NO3-, the nitrate ion. The NO3-, that nitrate ion, it stays together and it has a -1 charge, just like the sodium has a +1 charge. So how do you memorize these polyatomic ions? I recommend memorizing these common polyatomic ions at the minimum. And one way to do this is to practice lots and lots of naming and formula writing. After a while, the ions, they just become second nature. Flashcards can also be effective. And then there are some rules we can use to make sense of how polyatomic ions are named. Most polyatomic ions end in ITE or ATE. And here's the rule. Ions ending in ITE, they have one less oxygen than the ions that end in ATE. So if we look at the chart here, if we have sulfite, SO32-, that means sulfate is going to be SO42-. It has one more oxygen. An easy way to remember this is that 8 is greater because ite is just a byte. We can also see from the table that if we have elements on the periodic table, they usually end in IDE. So if I had the ion for sulfur, that would be S2-, and it would be the sulfide ion. Don't get ide and ite confused. IDE is for the periodic table, ITE, polyatomic ion table. So to help you remember, pause for a moment and try to complete this table. So we look at the table, we have NO2-, that's ite, so we're going to call this the nitrite ion. And then NO3-, we have one more oxygen, it ends in 8, we call that the nitrate ion. If we just have nitrogen, we're just looking at the nitrogen ion, that's going to end in IDE, and it'll be the nitride ion. Of course, for this to work, you do have to have either the nitrite or the nitrate ion memorized. I recommend memorizing the polyatomic ions that end in ATE. If you know these, you can use this rule to figure out the ones that end in ITE. Pause and give another one a try just to lock this into memory. So we know the PO43-, that's the phosphate. So PO33-, with one less oxygen, that's the phosphite. And then just P, that's the phosphorus ion, we call it the phosphide ion. And we can write IDE and ITE up on the top again as well. So finally, we can use the prefixes hypo and per when we write the names for common polyatomic ions. Hypo means one less oxygen than the compound that ends in ITE. So if I have ClO2- and I have one less oxygen, I get ClO-. And that's called hypochlorite ion. If I had something with chlorate, I would add per when I had one more oxygen. So here I have 3, I go to 4, instead of chlorate, I call this perchlorate. Note that most polyatomic ions don't have a compound that has hypo or per in the name. Chlorate is really the one that you'll see quite a bit. So the really important rule is the use of the ITE and the ATE. There are a few polyatomic ions that end in IDE, and the big one you want to memorize is hydroxide, OH-. This is used quite frequently in chemistry. The other one is the cyanide ion, CN-. This is also one you may want to memorize. Another kind of weird one is NH4+, the ammonium ion. Most polyatomic ions have negative charges, but this NH4+, that's one of the few that has a positive charge. So when we name a compound like NH4Cl, it's called ammonium chloride, we put the NH4 first because it's positive. The other one to remember is H3O plus. It's called the hydronium ion, and it's important in acid-base chemistry. People often ask about memorizing the charges on these polyatomic ions. Sorry, there's not really a simple rule for that. What about other ions? Well, if we look at the periodic table, there's a pretty simple trend for many of the elements. Group 1 has a plus 1 charge, group 2, plus 2. When we get to the part of the table with the transition metals, these charges vary, and we really need to look at how they bond and work backwards to figure out their charge. But there are three that always have the same charge, and you should memorize these. Zinc is always plus 2, silver always plus 1, and cadmium always plus 2. These are really worth committing to memory. This is Dr. B with probably more than you wanted to know about the list of common polyatomic ions. Thanks for watching.